Hi, I'm Bree from My Abiding Home, and today I'm going to show you how to make sourdough scones. I'm going to do orange cranberry today, and I will be using essential oils.
Welcome to My Abiding Home. This is a place where I share encouragement and discipleship, wholesome food, natural living, and some DIY. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe.
I would recommend using a food processor for this if possible. It just makes it quicker. You can grate up the butter instead. Make sure it's frozen if you're going to do that. And do it in a bowl with a dough scraper of sorts. So first we're going to begin by getting 2.5 cups of flour. Now, normally for this recipe and any baking recipe, I like to use einkorn all-purpose flour or einkorn whole wheat flour. Today I'm going to use unbleached all-purpose flour because that's what I have. So next we're going to add 12 tablespoons of butter. I would recommend grass-fed. I like the brand Kerrygold unless I can make it homemade raw butter. So you're going to cut it up into little, about 1-inch chunks. You want to work quickly with this so that your butter doesn't get too warm. It will cause your scones to be less flaky. So I'd recommend freezing your butter for 5 or 10 minutes before making this recipe, if possible. So next we're going to go ahead and pulse that a few times until it creates little pea-sized balls. Okay, so next we're going to go ahead and add 1/2 cup of sourdough starter. You can use inactive or active sourdough starter. Mine is actually active. I just fed it about 4 hours ago, so it's ready to go. Egg, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then you can use milk, milk kefir, buttermilk, whey, yogurt. For this recipe, I'm gonna go ahead and use 1/4 cup of yogurt today. Homemade is best. I don't have homemade right now, so. But it is organic. And then we're going to add 1/2 cup of honey. I do recommend raw local honey for that. It helps build up the immune system and fight sicknesses as well. You could use coconut sugar for this as well. I try to replace all my recipes with natural sugar, so I'm not using refined. If you live in my area, I would recommend CJ Hives for a good source of raw local honey. Also Provider Farms or anything that's in your area that's raw. We're gonna go ahead and pulse that a few times with the pastry attachment and the food processor. You do want to be careful not to overmix, just mix until it's just barely coming together. So next we're going to go ahead and get an organic orange. I've already washed it and we're going to grate some zest. About 1 teaspoon or so, I would say. And then we're going to go ahead and add the juice of a quarter of this orange. You could use a half if your orange is smaller. These are really large native oranges, so I'm going to go ahead and use only a quarter of it. And then I'm going to go ahead and add 2 drops of certified pure therapeutic grade essential oil. You do want to ensure the purity of the oils you're using. A lot of times they're adulterated with harmful oils, so. And then I'm going to go ahead, I don't have fresh cranberries since they're not in season. I'm going to add 1/4 cup of dried cranberries. 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder. And 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. And we are going to pulse that again. Make sure you only pulse right until it is mixed together. Do not overmix. Okay, then I'm going to go ahead and clear this area and add some flour to my cutting board and flatten it out to about 1.5 inches thickness. Got a little bit too much flour, but that means I'll have extra if it's a little bit wet. Since I normally make this with einkorn, I'm not sure if I have enough flour. So I'm going to go ahead and work on flattening that into a circle about 1.5 to 2 inches thick.
Then you're going to use a pizza cutter or dough scraper to cut the dough into 8 equal parts. Next, you're going to go ahead and add the scones to a parchment-lined pizza stone or baking sheet. Go ahead and pop that in the oven for 15 minutes. Keep an eye on it so it doesn't burn. And now it's time to make the glaze.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and start out by adding about 1/2 cup of confectioner's sugar to a small mixing bowl. And then we're going to go ahead and add just a splash or two of milk, about 1 teaspoon or 2. 1/2 of an orange, or 1/4 if it's really large. I'm again going to add some orange zest. And just give it a mix. That is a little bit runny, so I'm going to go ahead and add just a little bit more confectioner's sugar. You want it to be somewhat thick. This is a personal preference. Alright, so once you get it to your desired consistency, you're going to set it aside until your scones are done cooking and go ahead and just drizzle it across the top. Don't forget to add your essential oil, just 1 drop is plenty for the glaze. And that is all.
All right, well, it was such a joy to have you here. Thanks so much for stopping by. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for more encouragement and discipleship, wholesome food, natural living, and some DIY. Have a blessed day.